Having a highly accurate machine learning model that hasn't been tested is like buying a super fast car with a whole bunch of malfunctions. Imagine this conversation with a car dealer.
Hey, check out these two cars. One's got average speed, the other's lightning fast. Same price. Which one do you want?
Easy, the fast one. But why do they have the same price?
Well, the average speed car is pretty reliable, no malfunctions.
And?
To keep the other car super fast, it only goes in one direction. No need for mirrors or a steering wheel.
So, which car would you choose? Obviously not the flashy, malfunctioning one. Just like a car lacking safety features can be dangerous, an accurate machine learning model can cause problems if it exhibits unexpected behaviors that were not identified during testing. Testing the behaviors of a machine learning model can help us understand the strengths and weaknesses of the model and identify areas for improvement. In this video, I will cover three types of tests that assess different behaviors of your machine learning model. The first test is invariant testing. Invariant testing tests whether an ML model produces consistent results under different conditions. An example of invariant testing involves verifying if a model is invariant to paraphrasing. If a model is paraphrase variant, it might classify a positive review as negative when the review is rephrased using negative words. To implement this test, we use a Python framework for behavior-driven development called Behave. While PyTest is an option for implementing the test, Behave is better suited for defining and validating the behavior of machine learning models, as it offers great readability and a standardized language for expressing requirements. For those who prefer PyTest, I have included the test written in PyTest in the description below. To install Behave, type pip install behave. To use Behave for invariant testing, we will create two files inside the features directory. The first one is a feature file written by your business analyst or stakeholders. The second one is a step directory with Python step implementations for the scenarios. In this example, we will name our feature file invariant testing doc feature and our step file invariant testing doc py. The feature file describes a feature of a machine learning model. The description for the features is optional, but could be useful to define the goals of the test. The scenario includes three steps: given, when, and then. The given step establishes the initial state of the scenario, which is a text. The when step describes the action to be taken, which is to paraphrase the text. The then step describes the expected outcome of the scenario, which is that both the original text and the paraphrased text should have the same sentiment. Let's implement the steps in the file invariant testing.py. Steps are identified using the decorators given, when, and then. The decorator accepts a string containing the rest of the phrase in the matching step. Let's go through the implementation of each step. The given step sets a positive hotel review to the variable context.original. The context variable allows you to share values between different steps. For example, you can assess the value of context.original defined in the first step from the third step. The when step paraphrases the text using negative words. The then step finds the sentiment of the original text and the paraphrased text. The assertion checks whether both texts are either both positive or negative. Let's run the test by typing the command behave. The output shows that the first two steps passed and the last step failed. The failure indicates that both texts don't have the same sentiment and the model is affected by paraphrasing. If the model is sensitive to paraphrasing, then I'm just as sensitive to your liking of this video. So, if you enjoyed it, please take 1 second to hit the like button. The number of likes will give me a clear signal about whether you enjoyed this video and whether I should continue creating content like this. Thank you for hitting the like button. Directional testing is a testing method that assesses whether the impact of an independent variable on a dependent variable is in a particular direction, either positive or negative. An example of directional testing is to check whether the presence of a specific word has a positive or negative effect on the sentiment score of a given text. Let's create a feature file for this example. Even the sentence, I love this product, and the same sentence with the addition of the word awesome. When I input the new sentence into the model, the sentiment score should increase. This means that the presence of the word awesome should positively affect the sentiment score of the text. Let's implement the text used in the feature file. I'll skip explaining the implementation here since it is pretty straightforward. You can access the code examples in this video at the link in the description of this video. One thing to notice here is that the given step takes a sentence as input and sets it to the variable context.sent. Behave replaces the variables inside the brackets with the matching values in the feature file. In this case, it is I love this product. The following is output when running the test. Since all steps passed, we can infer that the sentiment score increases due to the presence of the new word. Minimum functionality testing verifies if the system or product meets the minimum requirements and is functional for its intended use. One example of minimum functionality testing is to check whether the model can handle different types of inputs, such as an integer, a float, or a list. In all these scenarios, the output is expected to be an array of one or three numbers, depending on the input type. The Python implementations for these scenarios can be found in the link in the description. Are you uncertain if your model is performing as expected? Why not try testing its behavior using the techniques you learned from this video? In addition to testing machine learning models, it's equally important to test the quality of your data to ensure it meets your expectations. In this upcoming video, you'll discover how to do exactly that using Pandera.